My field is the biological effects of radiation, and in the last decade or so we've become increasingly interested in the effects of far UVC light, potentially for benefit public health. Ultraviolet light, we typically divide it into three regions, and they're defined by the different wavelengths as UVA and UVB and UVC. What we're talking about here is the UVC component, which has been known for maybe 100 years now, that UVC is really incredibly efficient at killing viruses and bacteria. But it's been used much less in a public setting because of the potential for damaging the eye. What we proposed a decade ago is actually there is a particular range of wavelengths that we call far UVC, which don't have these human health hazards. Conventional germicidal UVC is typically about 254 nanometers in terms of its wavelength, whereas far UVC is down in the 220s. The 222 far UVC light really can't penetrate to living cells in the skin, and likewise in the eye. The first thing we did was set up some laboratory equipment to try and see whether we can kill airborne influenza viruses actually in the air with far UVC light, and it turned out that we could. So what we had was something which is potentially safe for human exposure, but lethal for an influenza virus in the air. When we think typically about disinfection using household products, we're generally thinking about disinfecting surfaces and floors and stuff like that. We're not really thinking about disinfecting the air. What far UVC has going for it is that, yes, it's okay at disinfecting surfaces, but it's very efficient at killing bacteria and viruses in the air, and that's really what we want. That's what causes the transmission of influenza or COVID. It's not the viruses and bacteria that are sitting on surfaces on countertops. It's the bacteria and viruses that are in the air that we breathe in. The future of far UVC depends on so many different factors, but we have continued to work to demonstrate both safety and efficacy. We're looking to see it installed in many different locations, in hospitals, in hotels, in restaurants, in offices, basically in any location where people are coming together for significant periods of time. We'd really love to have lots of far UVC lights in place when the next pandemic hits. And we know the next pandemic will hit, so we'd like to be in a position to prevent the next COVID from really taking its toll like the last one did. I must say that in installations where the far UVC actually is installed, the public has been incredibly accepting. I mean, the notion that you can go into a public place and worry a lot less about catching COVID or catching the next pandemic disease is pretty attractive. There's really no evidence of safety issues. That doesn't mean we don't continue to do safety studies. We can and we should and we will. But so far things are looking extremely positive.